1993, firemen attack a blaze at the famous theater in March 1993 at the corner of Marigny Street and North Claiborne. The building, constructed in 1913, was demolished later in 1993. Photo via the Times-Picayune archive by Mike Scott, M. Scott at NOLA.coma.j. Roquevert doesn't live in New Orleans anymore, having moved 21 years ago to Dallas for work. But as the manager of Canal Street's Joy Theater from 1979 to 1994, back when it was run by local movie theater icon Rene Brunet, he is well acquainted with the fascination many New Orleanians have when it comes to the city's old movie theaters. He knows because he's just as fascinated. As Rene said many times, every neighborhood had their own theater and everybody went to it, Roquevert said in a recent phone conversation, explaining why he thinks locals are still so smitten with their old, long-gone theaters. In the pre-television age, they went to the movies 3 times a week, consequently, a person's neighborhood theater, never more than a short streetcar ride away, was more than just another local business. It was almost like an extension of their living room. Roquevert knows what he's talking about, too. As the maker of the 2005 feature-length documentary, No More Joy, The Rise and Fall of New Orleans Theaters, he's a walking encyclopedia on the local movie theater industry. He also recently created an oversized poster of images of old New Orleans movie theaters, dedicated to Brunet's memory and which he hopes soon to make available through the Protania Theater, which is still run by Brunet's family. It's a break-even thing, he said of the poster project. It's a labor of love, local movie buffs will understand. They'll also understand why, after the enthusiastic reception NOLA.com readers gave to a gallery of vintage New Orleans movie theater photos published April 5th, we decided to dive back into the Times-Picayune's archives for a follow-up gallery. As with the first gallery, it's by no means comprehensive. There have been nearly 200 neighborhood theaters dotting the city's skyline over the years, after all. But it should serve as a nostalgic cinema flashback for local movie fans anyway.